To have you with us. What is Indonesia doing at the World Economic Forum this year?
Well, we are well represented this year. We have two ministers, myself and the trade minister. I'm Minister of Tourism and Creative Economy, and then we have like 12 members who are from the private sector and state-owned enterprises, and we will have an Indonesia night tomorrow night, just like we did last year. We call it Coco Night, Cooperation and Collaboration.
I've actually seen one of the lovely little ballets in Yogyakarta.
Ah, okay.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Is that the kind of stuff you're doing here?
We decided the place is too small for performance, so we're basically just serving good food, freshly cooked nasi goreng, okay, as well as rendang, and we will have some contemporary jazz Indonesian music.
Yeah. Okay. What is the mood like this year at the World Economic Forum?
I think it's gloomy because everybody's so concerned about the Eurozone crisis and the potential impact it has. But at the same time, people are saying, trying to look for new models, mm-hmm, you know, and new optimism or new opportunities for growth. And obviously, it's shifting. I think the last 2 years, it has been about the shifting of growth to Asia, you know,
yes,
sort of the north, south, east, west kind of shifting. Now we're not just talking about countries. Okay, everybody knows that emerging Asia, including Indonesia and India, are the opportunity and the growth in the forthcoming near future. But at the same time, how do you have better ways of collaboration?
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you've got the multilateral systems also being put under a lot of stress and testing. So there needs to be more collaboration, whether it's regional within a region or between private sector and
public sector,
and then within communities. I think what's interesting is, I think there will be a new, I'll be attending some of the sessions because I think both India and Indonesia are part of it, which is this what they call the new economy,
mm-hmm,
sort of the digital based economy, which is so much part of our growth now.
Yes.
And that's why we created this ministry now called Creative Economy. And you know, I was just looking at the Facebook statistics. Indonesia is number two and India is number three, but we're very close. 42.8 million users of Facebook in Indonesia, and for India it's
42.3
as of today. So you know, and,
social
and that's
workers.
yeah the social media and the apps that go into it,
yes,
it's creating a whole new economy,
and
allowing young people to become entrepreneurs and creating jobs. Yeah,
but it's more than that, isn't it? It's also collaborating.
Yes, collaborating. You know, it's like it can be unorganized. We've had many examples. I'm sure India has had the same experience where either for a cause or for disseminating a business information or a product, it's viral, you know, and sometimes it's not organized.
But isn't that also the nature of our communities?
Yes.
Aren't India,
yes,
and Indonesia traditionally like this?
Yes.
And is it why it's
That's
working
right.
so well?
I think so, because we're used to like what you're doing here, hanging out, yeah, talking to each other and being part of a community. And I think that's certainly similarity between India and Indonesia.
Yeah. But is it also that we are taking to the new medium because it lets us be like, we're not a broadcast society. We're more informal.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, and basically with Facebook, you know, it's basically it's not an anonymous community. It's, you know, it's somebody you know,
yes,
right? And then it's somebody who knows who somebody you know, you know. So there's that kind of community feeling. And I understand you went to Merapi, to Borobudur. One of the interesting examples is after the actual eruption of Merapi, there was a community that came out for volunteering,
mm-hmm,
and it was commanded by two, three young people who are IT competent, but they organized the whole relief effort through that, so that you know, okay, this location needs help for food. Oh, already enough food. Go to this other location. This was all done by Twitter.
All right.
Yes. So I think it's very powerful when it can work. Yeah.
So, what are the examples that India and Indonesia will set? What is it, the examples that they will set?
I think India and Indonesia have many similarities. We are both democracies which are consolidating. We have very open and free information, and the growth of the creativity, I think, in both countries is wonderful. Whether you're talking about fashion, handicraft, or a lot of the IT-based industries, and we are now much more closely connected because, at least with ASEAN, India We have already a free trade agreement between India and ASEAN, and we are exploring how we can make this also in the bilateral sense. So I think India and Indonesia both stand to play a greater role in Davos, as well as in the regional fora and in the more global multilateral fora.
And where do you think are going to be the greatest areas of mutual cooperation?
I think on investment and trade and tourism and creative economy, mm-hmm. in all these three areas, great potential. There's already a lot of Indian investments interested to come to Indonesia, and vice versa, Indonesian investments going to India in quite different sectors because mm-hmm. of the different competitiveness and needs. Like Indians will come looking for resources, Indonesians are going there for consumer-related industry, real estate, and so on. And then for the trade, India needs coal and palm oil and hopefully other manufactured products from Indonesia. We could certainly import more machinery and use of your IT services from India. And infrastructure, that's, I think, another strength of India. And on tourism and creative economy, we'd like to see more Indian tourists come to Indonesia. And hopefully there will be a direct flight from Garuda starting this year between New Delhi and Bali. So hopefully that will...
There are great civilizational links as well.
Yes, right? Yes. The Ramayana and the Hindu culture, which is still quite strong in Indonesia. And on the creative economy, I think there's a lot of potential there. I mean, I have been talking to a lot of the people in India, say the film industry, mm-hmm. Animation, any of the IT-based industries. I think those would be very good collaboration for the future.
So when we say Brand India, what does Brand India mean to you?
Well, I think you've done a good job. I've been following what India's been doing since 2006. I went to a number of the Indian nights, including the soiree, and I think back when Kamal Nath was still trade minister, I went to a number of the Bollywood events, and they were very, I think, very clever. And what I think appreciated the most about Brand India is the collaboration between the private sector and the government seems to be working so well, and there's the commitment from both sides. And I think 5 years on, I think it's stuck. You know, it takes that long for brand to stick. So I think the Brand India, Incredible India, and what you're doing here is all part of a theme that is strong, and I wish you well, and I think it's a good strategy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Okay.